Hello all, welcome to my channel. Today I will demonstrate you how to create, append, display, how to insert, update, delete, search and sort the record of the structure into the file. So let's do the same thing practically. First of all, I want to just declare the structure. So I'm just writing here struct student. Then here you can declare the structure member. For example, I'm just declaring here integer roll number. Then I'm just declaring here character name of 20. So I can store the name of 20 character max. Then I'm just declaring structure within structure, and that is a structure subject. Here inside the structure subject, I want to store the subject code. Then I want to store the subject name of 20 characters. Then I want to store the marks of the subject, but I want to fix the subject. So I'm just creating an array of structure, and that is subject of 3. Then here you can declare the integer total and you can declare the float percentage. Now I want to declare the variable student, and I want to declare the variable of type student. So I'm just declaring here, that is the type def struct student. So I will just denoting here type def, that is a student. So using student, I can declare the variables in main. And that is what you can declare the student S1, student S2 like that. Let me start with this particular program with the menu first. So I'm just writing here integer choice. Now here you can write the do while choice not equal to 0. Now here you can simply print the statement. For example, I want to do what? That is, I want to create the file first. Then I want to display the content of the file. So I'm just adding the one more option, and that is display. And then I want to append the record. So I'm right now just adding the three options, that is create, display and append. And whenever user says that I want to press the 0, then it will simply exit from the menu. Now here I just want to ask to the user, and that is what /n enter your choice. So if user says that I want to do create, so definitely the choice will be 1. I'm writing here scanf percentage d ampersand choice. Now here you can pass this particular choice into switch case. So what happened in this particular case? If it is a case 1, then I want to call simple one function, and that is create, right? So definitely what we will do, we will just simply create the record into the file. And whenever user says that I want to display the content, then we will simply call the function display, and here we can say break. And if it is a case 3, then we will call the function append, and simply we will break from the loop. So this is what the switch case is, and this will work until and unless user press the case 0. Definitely we need to create here three function, and that is what void create function. We need a function void display. We need a function that is void append. Now I'm simply running this particular application, that is build and run. Whenever you test this particular application, it will asking you for the menu. For example, if you say 1, then definitely it will 1, 2, 3, all the menu will working fine. If you say 0, then you will simply exit from the program. Now whenever user click on the first option, that is create, I want to ask to the user that how many records you want, how many students you want, and then I want to store the same into the file. So definitely we need to work into the create function. So what I'm doing here, see carefully, I'm just declaring here one variable, that is student pointer s. Why pointer? Because might be a chance user can enter the I want the 50 student, and user can says that I want only one student. So it is not defined yet. So I'm just declaring here pointer s. Definitely we need a number of students. So I'm declaring here variable n, I for each student and j for each subject mark. Now I'm just asking to the user that enter how many students you want. Suppose user says that I want 5 students, then definitely percentage d ampersand n. Now whenever user says that I want 5 students, so we will simply run our loop I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, And here we can simply ask to the user that printf enter roll number. So definitely we will ask to the user that scanf %d ampersand. Now we need to allocate the memory to our pointer s variable. So I'm just writing here s is equal to, you can cast it into student pointer. You can call the function that is calloc. How many times you want to allocate the memory? N times. And what is the memory size? That is the size of the student. So the memory will be allocated to variable s, and here you can write enter roll number address of s of I. Now not only roll number, we need a name also. So we can ask to the user that enter name. But whenever you say is that enter name, definitely we need a value that contains the space also. So we can ask to the user that percentage not slash n up to s. So it will simply ask to the user that enter the value of name, enter the name. So we will just get the value s of I dot name. But what happened in this particular case, your slash n will be entered into this particular scanf, and that is the reason why it will not get the value. So we just need to flush the memory. So we can write here f flush std in. Now once it is done, you can just use the j loop to access the mark of the student. So you can write j equal to 0, j less than 3. Why? Because there are 3 students. J plus plus. Here you can just write printf enter marks of, now here you can just write percentage d, marks of subject 1, subject 2, subject 3. So you can write j plus 1, scanf percentage d address of s of I dot. Now we have one variable that is subject variable, this that is an array. So subject of j dot mark. So what happened in this particular case, this my subject of j is, that is the subject of 3, is declared as a structure within structure. So s of I is a student representation, and this subject of j is a, for each subject it will get the mark of the student. Now I want to calculate the total also. So what we can do here, very simple, we can write here that is s of I dot total is equal to 0. Even you can write s of I dot percentage is equal to 0. Now I want to calculate the total, so I can write here s of I dot total plus is equal to s of I dot subject of j dot mark. So your mark will be added to total. Once all the marks is added to the total, you can calculate the percentage. So you can write here s of I dot percentage is equal to s of I dot total divided by 3.0. why? Because there are 3 subjects, but I want to write this data into the file. So whenever you want to write the data into the file, we need a file pointer fp. So what we can do here, we can simply open our file, that is fp is equal to f open. Here we can give the name of our file. For example, name of my file is mystudents.txt. I want to open this file in a write mode. Why? Because it is a create option. So I want to recreate every time whenever user says that I want to create the file. So I'm just using the file mode that is write mode. And after this done, here you can simply close your file, and here you can simply write your data address of, that is you can write here address of s of I, size of student 1 and fp. So your data will be written to the file. Once your data is written to the file, I want to read the data. So how we can read the data? It is very simple. I want to call the function that is display. Here we can write the code in a display. So what we can write, very simple, for each record I want the data. So I'm just declaring variable student s1. Here you can just declare the file pointer fp. You can just open that particular file, that is fp is equal to f open. The name of the file is mystudents.txt. I want to now open this file in a read mode, and I will simply close my file. Now I want to read the data. So how we can read the data? Very simple. You can just write while, you can call the function fread of address of s1. So it will simply read the one by one each and every record, and size of student 1 and FP. If the record is available, then it will be read into the variable S1. So you can simply print here. For example, I just want to print percentage minus 5D percentage minus 20S. What I want to print? S1.RNO comma S1.name. And I want to call the J loop to print the marks. So I'm just writing here J equal to 0, J less than 3, J plus plus. And here you can print percentage, for example, 4D. And I want to print the S1 dot subject of J dot mark. And now at the last, you can simply print percentage 5D percentage 7.2F. You can print the S1 dot total and S1 dot percentage. Once it is done, you can check your program is working fine or not. Definitely we need a variable, and that is integer J. Now we can simply build and run. Whenever you run this particular application, now it will give me an option what you want to do. I want to create first. So it is asking me how many records you want, how many students you want. I want the 3 students. So I'm just entering the record, that is 101. For example, name of the person is Devin Patel. Marks is 65, 67 and 78. 102, name of the person is, for example, Kapil Shukla. Marks are 76, 88 and 98. 103, name of the person, for example, Dharmik. You can enter the marks, that is, for example, 34, 56 and 67. You can display the content, and here you can check that the record are displayed. But I want to append the data also. So whenever you want to append, you can use the third option, and that is the case number 3, that is append. Whenever you want to append the data, you can simply copy your content. You can simply copy your content of create and you can paste into append. What is the difference between create and append? That is the only difference, and that is what, instead of W, you can open your file in an append mode. Now you can test your program again, and what happened whenever you run this 2-4 display, it will display the 3 record. Now I want to append the data, for example, 2 more, and that is 104. For example, Tatsat, marks are 67, 87 and 44. 105, name is, for example, Maharshi. The marks are 76, 78, 78 and 89. 2-4 display. Now you people will be able to see that there are 2 records with the same ID. So in this situation, I want to delete the record. So whenever you want to delete, we need to add the option over here. So that we will do. Now we want to add one more option, and that is what? 1-4 create, 2-4 display, 3-4 append. Now I want a total number of records. So here you can just add the option, and that is 4th option, and that is find the number of records, and that is how many records are there. In 5th option, what I want to do, if it is an option number 5, then I want to search a record. So I want to write the code for this 2 option. So you can simply copy this particular case and you can paste. If it is a case 4, then I want to find the number of records. So you can call the function that is number of records. Case 5, then I want to search for the record. So you can call the function that is search. Definitely, I need to create the function, and that function is number of record and search. So what we can do here? Very simple. Here we can declare the function that is void number of record. Void number of record. We can create the function that is void search. Now, whenever user says that I want the number of record, we can just declare here student S1. We can just open our file, and that is file pointer FP. FP is equal to fopen, which is your file, that is mystudents.txt. Open that file in a read mode. Now here you can just use the function fseek. You can set your position at 0 and you can seek up to end. So if you want the number of record, then you can just get the current position using ftel of fp, and you can divide by size of the record. So you will get the total number of record. Once you get the total number of record, here you can simply print, that is /n/n number of records is equal to %d, and here you can print your variable, that is n, and here you can just write f close of fp. Now you can simply build and run your application, and you will be able to see that, for example, if I says that 2 for display, and if I says that 4 for number of records, it says that there are 5 records are there. Even you can insert the record and you can check, it will be updated. For example, 3 for append, I want to add one more record, and that is 106. For example, name of the person is Ankit Faldu, and the marks are this. Now if I says the total number of records, then it will says that the number of records is equal to 6. So it is working fine. Now I want to write the code for searching, and whenever you want to write the code for the searching, we need to ask to the user that enter the roll number to search. Whenever you want to do the searching, you can just copy your code of display. Whenever you want to do the searching, you can just copy your code of display. Just copy that particular code and paste into search. Now what happened in a display? It will simply display all the records, but I don't want to display all the records, right? So whenever user says that search, for example, if I'm running this particular code, and if user says that 5, it will display all record, but I don't want to display all record. I want to display selected record. So here you can just write a one condition, and that is what? Printf, enter roll number to search. So which roll number you want to search? Scanf, %d, ampersand, for example, RNO. So definitely I need to declare one variable, that is roll number. So if roll number and the roll number that is available in the file, if both are matched, then and then I want to display the content. So here you can simply write, if s1.rno equal rno, then display the content. So I don't want to display this if it is not found. So here you can just close your if bracket, and here you can mention that if it is found, then you can just assign found is equal to 1. If not found, then you can simply print the message, and that is record not found. And here you can write /n/n. Now here you can simply build and run. Definitely what happens, see, I need to declare one variable over here, and that is found is equal to 0. Now you can just call build and run. What happened in this particular case? If I says that 5 and search for the roll number 111, it will says that record not found. Yes, it is not available. But if I says that option number 5 and search the roll number 106, what happens? See, Ankit Faldu is displaying over here. If I am searching again, and if I says that the roll number 104, then it will display the 2 records. Why? Because there are 2 records having the same roll number, right? So this is the way you can search. You can pass any number and you can get the value. Now I want to update the data. So whenever you want to update the data, you need to add a new case over here, and that will be what? Printf /n/6, and that is update. So whenever you want to update, definitely you need to call here one function, and that is update function. So here, instead of search, we will make it here, that is update. Whenever you want to call the function update, definitely I recommend everyone to copy the content of search, because whenever you want to update, the content will be similar to search. Why? Because instead of displaying in a search, we need to update the data. So here we will do what? We will just rename the name of our function, and that will be, instead of search, make it here update. Now here it is asking me enter the roll number to update. Now if roll number are matched, then we will not display the content, but instead we will ask the user to enter the new data. So whenever you want the new data, what we can do, we can just copy the content from that is append or create. So you can just copy this particular content, and here you can paste into your update. So here you can paste. Now what happens? If record is found, then we will ask to the user that enter new name. We will ask to the user that enter new marks. So it will asking me, that is the enter new name and enter new marks. Now, if the record are matched, then definitely my pound will be 1. So whenever you want to update the data, definitely your data is available from the reading, it is available from the mystudent.txt. But at the same time, we need a one more file to write the data. So I'm just writing here *fp1. Why I'm declaring one more file over here, and that is a *fp1, just because I'm just managing the temporary file. So I'm just writing here, that is temp.txt. I'm opening that particular file in write mode. Now, what I want to do, if the data is matched, then I will simply update the data. If data is not matched, then it will be as it is. And I'm simply writing the data into, that is the fwrite address of S1, size of student, and we can write the data into, that is fp1. So what happened? Updated data will be written to your temp.txt file. Once your data is written to the fp1, you can simply close both the file, that is fp, and you can close the file, that is fp1. So what happened in this particular case, both the file will be closed. Now, if the record is found, then what you want to do, and if record is not found, then what you want to do? If the record is found, then we will simply open our date file, that is temp.txt, into read mode. Why? Because the data, that is updated data, is available in temp.txt, that we need to replace with the our original file. So in original file, we need to write the content of the temp.txt. So I'm just writing what, that is fp1 is equal to temp.txt, fp is equal to f open, and that is mystudents.txt. I will open that file in a write mode. Now you can definitely close both the file, that is fp, and you can close the file, that is fp1. Now no need to write this f close over here. Now here in between, we just need to read the content from the temp.txt, and then we can write into the mystudent.txt. So let's just check what we can do here. You can just use the loop, that is while fread. Here you can write address of S1, size of student 1, fp. You can read the content, and line by line you can write into, that is the same record you can write into, that is fp. So what happens, see, we need to read from the fp1, and that we can write into fp. It means the data is available in temp.txt that we will read, and that we can write into the mystudent.txt. But if and only if it is a found. So if the data is found, then we can simply write like this. Let me check, build and run. But whenever you write build and run, what happens, see, your data is read into S1. So you need to make the changes here, and that is s1.name. Here you can write s1.subjectofj. Here you can write s1.subjectofj. Here you can write s1.total. Here you can write s1.percentage. Now here you can simply build and run. Again, I need to make the changes here, that is s1.total. And now you can just write build and run. I just need to write a semicolon over here. Now you can just simply build and run. I just need to mention here the case 6, and then you can just simply build and run. Now it is working fine. Now whenever you run this particular application, you can display the content. This is the content. Now I want to change the name. Instead of Dharmik, I want to make it here Sandeep Ramani. So the roll number of the Dharmik is 103. So here you can just pass 6 for update. So it will asking me enter the roll number to update, and that is 103. Now it is asking me new name. For example, I am entering here Sandeep Ramani. Now here you can enter the marks, and whenever you display the content, you will be able to see that the Sandeep Ramani record is inserted over here. If you look carefully, then the record of Sandeep Ramani is changed, and here the total is not perfect. Why? Because the in old total, the record are adding. So how to resolve this? It is very simple. If the roll number match, or if it is not match, here you can do what? That is s1.total is equal to 0. s1.percentage is equal to 0. Once it is done, You can simply rerun your application. Now what happened? You can just try to check your data. For example, I want to just update the data. So I'm just writing here 6 for update. Now I'm entering the same roll number, that is 103. Here I'm just giving the name, that is Sandeep Ramani. Now here I'm just giving the marks, for example, 67, 87 and 89. Now here you can display the content and you will get the accurate result over here. So this is what the update is. Now I want to delete the data. So whenever you want to delete the data, here you can simply write what? That is, you can just simply copy the case 6. Here instead of 6, you can just write 7. And I want to delete the record. So I'm just writing here, that is delete REC. So definitely I need to create one function, and that is delete record. So definitely I need to add the case over here, that is print number 7, and that is delete. Now I want to delete the content. I recommend everyone, whenever you want to delete, you can just simply copy the content of update. You can simply copy the content of update, and whenever you want to delete, you can just give the name over here, and that is, for example, delete record. Now enter the roll number to delete. For example, whenever you want to delete the record, what we need to do? We don't need to get the value from the user. So we can simply set here, if the roll number and number are matching, then simply set the found is equal to 1. And if it is not matching, then write into temp file. If it is not matching, then write into temp file. If it is found, then replace the temp file with the original file and your content will be deleted. You can simply build and run your application. And now you can check, see, there are 6 records are there. Now I want to delete both this, that is 104, Tatsat and Mercy both. So whenever you want to delete this, you can just pass the option number 7. You can pass the roll number, for example, 104. 2 records will be deleted, and here you can check the content. There are only 4 records are there. Whenever you check 4, you will get only number of records are 4. And whenever you search for the number, for example, 5104, then it will say that the record not found. So this is the way you can delete the data. Now, suppose if you think that, sir, I want to sort the data. So how we can sort the data? For example, I want to sort by total. So I'm just writing here 8, sort by total, and that is descending. But I want to just do the same thing on the screen only, right? So sort by total descending on screen. And I want to do the same thing on the file also. So here you can write sort by total descending in file. So there will be 2 options. One is 8, that is sort by total descending. 9, that is sort by total descending in file. So whenever you want to do this, you can just add the option over here, that is case number 8. When it is case number 8, sort by total, and it will be on screen, right? So this is my function, sort by total on screen. And here you can just write your case number 9, and that is what? Sort by total, and that is in file. That is in file. And here also you can write the break. So definitely I need to create the two functions. Definitely I need to create the two functions, and that is what? For example, void sort by total on screen, void sort by total in file. So you can just build and run, and you can check if it is an error, then it will definitely shows an error. Here you can just display the content. Yes, it is working fine. Now I want to sort the data by total. It means Kapil Shukla should be displayed first, and then Sandeep Ramani, and then Ankit Faldu, and then Devan Patel. So whenever you want to sort the data by total on the screen, so definitely what we can do over here, that is very simple. Here you can declare the two variable. One is for the n number of records, that is pointer s, and for the one record you can declare the s1. Now we need to read the data from file, so I'm just declaring here file pointer fp equal to fopen. You can open your file mystudents.txt. You can open your file into read mode. Now you can simply close your file, so you can write here fclose of fp, Now what we can do here, we want to know the how many records are there. So we can write here fseq of fp and then 0, and then you can write seq underscore and. So your cursor will be moved to your and, then you can just ask for the, then you can just calculate the number of record by writing here, that is ftel of fp divided by size of student. So what happened, it will simply get the number of record. Now I'm just rewinding my cursor, so my cursor will be set to the first position, that is the beginning of the file. Now I want to write all the data into S, so definitely we need to allocate the memory to S. So I'm writing here S is equal to student pointer calloc, and here you can allocate the n records to the, that is the n record size to the S variable, that is S pointer variable. Now here you can read your data into S, so you can write I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. You can read your data into S of I, so you can write address of S of I, size of student 1 and fp. So your all data will be read into your S of I variable. Now I want to sort the data, so I will simply write the loop, that is I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. Here you can write another loop, that is j equal to, for example, I plus 1, j less than n, j plus plus. And now we will compare the value by total. So I'm just writing here if S of I dot total is less than S of j dot total, then it will be in a descending order. Then you can write S1, that is the record, is equal to S of I. And you can write S of I is equal to S of j. S of j is equal to S1. And simply you can print the value. So whenever you want to print the value, you can simply write here, and that is what, for I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. You can copy this particular display content from your display method. So you can just move to your display method, and this is display. So you can just copy this particular content, copy this, and here you can paste inside this. So what happened, your roll number, name and all these things will be displayed, but instead of S1 we will write here, that is S of I, because the data is available now in S of I. So here I just need to make what, that is, this is not s1.rno, is it will be S of I.rno, it will be S of I.name, it will be S of I.subject of j dot mark, it will be S of I dot total, it will be S of I dot percentage. Now you can simply build and run your application. Definitely I need to declare the variable integer I and j. So you can simply build and run. Whenever you run this particular code, you will be able to see that 2, 4 display, these are the record. But if you say that 8, that is sort by total, then you will be able to see that the Kapil Shukla record is coming first, then Sandeep Ramani, then Ankit Faldu, and then Deven Patel. Now I want to sort this permanently. What happens, see, whenever you say is that the 2-4 display, the record is not set permanently here, right? So I want to sort the data by total permanently into the file. So whenever you want to do this permanently, you can just copy this particular code, that is by total. You can copy this and you can just paste into the in file. So what now change is required? Very simple. Whenever you display this, definitely you can display, but now you need to open your file. So you can simply close this file. Once it is read, you can simply close your file, that is fp. Now here you can open after sorting. After sorting, you can open your same file, that is fp is equal to f open mystudents.txt. You can open it into write mode. Now you can write this S of I, that is the sorted data, into your file. So you can write f write address of, that is S of I, size of student, address of S of I, size of student 1 and file pointer. Then you can simply close your file. So now you can simply build and run. Whenever you run this, you will be able to see what that is the existing record. For example, if you say is that 2, then these are the 4 records, but I want to sort by total on the screen. So I'm just using the option that is 8, and you will be able to see that the highest total mark will be displayed first. But if you display again same record, then the data will be sorted by roll number only, right? So I want to permanent make the changes by sort by total descending into the file, then you need to use the option number 9. And whenever I use the option number 9, the data will be sorted permanently. Even if you say is that 2 for display, you will get the data by sorted by, that is a total, and that is in a descending order. Now suppose if you think that, sir, I want to sort by name. So whenever you want to sort by name, at that time you can simply do what? You can add the 10th option over here, and that is what, for example, let me copy this. I want to add the 10th option that is on screen. I want to sort by name. So I want to sort by the name of the student. So this is the 10th option, and here you can just simply copy your case number 8 and you can paste over here, and you can write case number 10. Now I want to sort by name on the screen. So definitely I need to create the function that is sort by name on the screen. So I'm just creating one function over here that is sort by name on screen. Whenever you want to do this, you just need to copy your function. That is, you need to copy your content, and that is sort by total on the screen. So you can just simply copy this and you can paste into the function that you just need created right now, and that is sort by name on screen. Now you just need to change a one condition over here, and that is what? S of I dot name, and here you can just write S of J dot name. But whenever you want to compare the string, here you can use the comma, and here you can use the function that is strcmp. Now here you can just close your bracket, and here you can write the condition, and that is what? If S of I name is greater than the S of J dot name, then replace the same. So what happened in this particular case, it will sort by the name in the ascending order. You can just build and run this particular application, and you will be able to see that, for example, if you press here option number 2, this is the sorted by total. But if you say that option number 10, then the record will be sorted by name. Here you will get the record by sorted by name. And if you say that 8, then the record will be sorted by the total. And if you say 10, then the record will be sorted by name. So this is the way you can use, these are the option that is insert, update, delete, search, sort, edit, number of records, append, all these things you can do in a file handling using the structure. So that's it from my side. If you like this video, then please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you all. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.